In a meeting held today at Conference Hall of Hotel Saramati, Dimapur, Kikheto Sema, Agriculture Production Commissioner and overall in charge of COVID-19 activities in Dimapur, along with DC of Dimapur and Commissioner of Police, held a meeting with various Dimapur-based civil society organizations to deliberate on the district COVID-19 situation. The following decisions were made. All returnees who have completed 14 days of institutional quarantine and show no symptoms may be allowed to go to the respective districts without mandatory testing, and those from Dimapur district be released from home quarantine. Even after completion of 14 days, any returnee showing symptoms will be retained and tested in Dimapur. They also decided that they have no objection if the government takes a decision to retain all COVID-positive returnees pertaining to Mon and Perin districts. If they are to be retained at Dimapur, the state government may urgently identify one more COVID hospital. It is suggested that all fresh returnees be sent to the respective districts after thorough screening and triaging of the returnees due to paucity of resources. Once the above suggestions is accepted, the state government may bring back the stranded Naga citizens from other states as well. The state government on May 29 constituted a three-member judicial inquiry committee to probe into the matter regarding the transportation of returnees to Tuen Sang. The decision comes following a representation submitted by the Eastern Nagaland People's Organization to initiate disciplinary action against those officials involved in the deliberate violation of the standard operation procedures and related matters. The Judicial Inquiry Committee will be headed by retired District and Sessions Judge L.N. Sema as chairman and two members, Advocate Akum Jamir and Advocate Y. Sangtam. The committee will submit its report within 15 days from the date of issue of the notification, Principal Secretary Home Abhijit Sinha stated. Nagaland Board of School Education today declared provisional results of the HSLC and HSSLC examinations 2020, with girls outperforming boys once again except in HSSLC Commerce stream, where the boys with 68.99% fared better than the girls with 66.44%. In HSLC, a total of 22,393 candidates were enrolled, and in the HSSLC, a total of 15,461 were enrolled for the examinations. Abhi Chakraborty of Holy Cross Higher Secondary School, Dimapur, who scored 98.33%, topped the HSLC examination 2020. Termed as Unlock 1, the Ministry of Home Affairs has issued a new set of guidelines to facilitate a phase-wise dilution of the coronavirus consequent lockdown. The guidelines issued today will be effective till June 30th, and the first phase is set to have an economic focus. The Home Ministry has lifted almost all restrictions placed under the lockdown. However, the onus to implement relaxations has been put on state governments considering the prevalent COVID-19 situation in their respective states. Details of Unlock 1 guidelines. Only essential activities will be allowed in containment zones till June 30th. Three phases of relaxations have been announced. Phase 1. Ministry of Home Affairs has issued national directives for COVID-19 management, including compulsory use of face masks and social distancing norms. In Phase 2, schools, colleges, educational institutions, coaching centers will be opened after consultations with states and union territories. In Phase 3, dates for the reopening of international air travel of passengers, operation of metro rail, cinema halls, gymnasiums, swimming pools, entertainment parks will be decided based on the assessment of the situation. Night curfew timings has been revised and movement of individuals will be prohibited between 9 p.m. and 5 a.m. across the country. Ministry of Home Affairs said that consultations will be held with states and union territories and other stakeholders on reopening of academic institutions from July. With rising COVID-19 positive cases all across the nation and in the northeastern region as well, the status update of the northeastern states are: Arunachal has 3 positive cases with 1 discharged and 2 active cases. Assam has 1,101 positive cases, 164 discharged, 930 active, and 4 deaths. Meghalaya has 27 positive cases with 12 discharged, 14 active, and 1 death. Manipur has 60 positive cases, 6 discharged, 54 active, with no deaths. Mizoram has 1 positive case and 1 discharged. In Nagaland, the positive cases rose to 36. Tripura has 254 positive cases, 167 discharged and 87 active. Sikkim has one positive case in the tally. From all of us here at NE8, stay safe.